Hello friends, I welcome you all to my channel Bell's Institute. Today we will see assembly language program for string manipulation operation. In this string manipulation operation, we will consider following operations: accepting string from user, finding its length, finding reverse of the string and checking whether string is palindrome or not. So this is our problem statement. Write ALP to perform following operations on string: find and display length, display reverse, check whether string is palindrome or not, display proper strings to prompt the user while accepting the output and displaying the result. Write near procedures to complete the task. Before moving towards actual logic and program, we will see the program structure first. This is the simple macro written for message display, which we have seen already in hex to decimal, decimal to hex conversion. The same macro is written over here. Then we have used small memory model. This is our data section. Data section contains two strings, str1 and str2. All contains 25 bytes and each is filled with a dollar sign. Dollar is nothing but the null character. Then we have declared various messages which will be required throughout the code: menu to enter, to show the menu, to show the messages, display messages to the user. We will require this all messages entire for the execution of your program. Then next is the code section. Code section contains different function. This function is to accept the string from user, accept. Then this procedure is to display the length of the string to the user. This procedure is to reverse the given string. Okay, reverse. And this procedure is to check whether string is palindrome or not. And this is our main function, start. Okay, so now when exe is executed, then program starts from this point, start. Move ax comma at the rate data, move ds comma x. So data section will be initialized, and then menu, display message 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So this will display this menu on the screen. Menu, enter string, length, reverse, palindrome, exit. Accept the choice, move ah, 01h, int 21h. These two instructions read the value entered by user and store it in AL register. So consider that by reading this message, enter your choice, user entered choice 1. Okay, so by these two instructions, move ah, 01h, int 21h, this value will be read and this value will be stored in AL register. AL contains 31, 31 is the ASCII value for 1. Move AL, BL. So whatever is in AL register, that will be moved to BL register. So now BL will contain 31. Compare BL, 31. Check whether the choice is 1. Compare BL with 31. Yes, it is equal. BL is equal to 31. So jump if equal, JE. Jump if equal to ACC. So what is written in ACC? ACC is the label which contains the instruction call accept. So control will be transferred to accept procedure. Accept procedure is written over here. Accept procedure. Accept procedure, first instruction is display message 9. So message 9 will be displayed. What is message 9? Enter the string. Next instruction is LEADX, STR1. So now STR1 contains the address of locations where the string 1 is to be stored. We are moving this address STR1 to DX register. Okay, so now DX register will point here, DX register. Okay, by reading this message, enter the string. Let's say user enters welcome, string welcome on the screen. So by this instruction, move ah, 0 ah, int 21 h. This string entered by user will be moved here, welcome, and then remaining dollars. Why here? Because this location is pointed by DX register. Move ah, 0 ah, int 21 h. 0 ah code, the job of 0 ah code is to read the string and store it at the address which is pointed by DX register. That's why we transfer contents of str1 to DX first, and then we call this interrupt move ah, 0 ah and int 21 h. So by this way, your string or a string entered by user will be stored at location str1. Next is return. So obviously it will return to the main procedure, and it will come here at this instruction. Call accept, we have called call accept, and we call the accept procedure. So when it will return, it will return to this instruction. This instruction is jump menu. So again it will go here, jump menu, and it will display menu. Now consider that user enters choice 2. User enters 2. So again 2 is read into AL register. From AL it is moved to BL register. Okay, so here compare BL, 31. Check whether choice is 1. No, so it will come here. Jump is equal to accept, so it will not go to accept, it will come here. Compare BL, 32. Yes, they are equal. Jump is equal to len. So what is written in len? Len contains call length, so it will call length function. Okay, length, it will come here. Display message 11. Display message 11 means length is. Next instruction to display is move DL, STR1 plus 1. Now see here, STR1 contains the address of the string, and STR1 plus 1 means next location just after STR1 contains the length of the string. So here we can see this. This is STR1 which contains the address of the string, and STR1 plus 1, it is the next location to STR1 which contains the length of the string. So here in this case length is 7. So STR1 plus 1 contains 7. This is by default. So move DL, STR1 plus 1. So whatever is there in STR1 plus 1 will be moved here. DL is equal to 07. Add DL, 30. Add 30, because now we have to display this length on the screen, and to display on the screen we need it in ASCII form. So add 30, and then move ah, 0 to h, int 21 h. So the job of 02 is to display the length, and it will display the value which is stored in DL register. So length is displayed as 7, because DL register contains 37. 37 is the ASCII value of 7. So next instruction is return. So length is displayed, and now return. Return means again it will go here, from where it is called jump menu. It will again display the menu. Now suppose user enters 3. So 3 will be stored again here. 3 will be stored in AL register. It will be copied to BL register. BL is compared with 31. No, it is not 31. It will come here. 32. No, it's not 32. It will come here. 33. Yes, jump if equal to rev. Rev. So what is written in rev? Call reverse. So it will call reverse procedure. Reverse procedure is written over here. Okay. So now, in reverse procedure, first instruction is display message 10. So display message 10. What is message 10? Reverse string E. It will display reverse string E. Next instruction is XOR CH, CH. It will make register CH 0. If you XOR the bit with the same bits, 0 XOR 0 is 0, 1 XOR 1 is also 1. So if you XOR the number with same number, result will be 0. Similarly, here whatever are the CH content XOR with the same content, the result will be 0. So this will make the CH 0. Next instruction, move CL, str 1 plus 1. Now str 1 plus 1 contains the length of the string, and that we are moving to CL register. Okay, so our CH is 00 and CL is 07. Subtract CL, 01. So 1 will be subtracted, CL is 06. Okay, now why this 1 is subtracted from the length? Because now by using this counter, we have to move the SI pointer to this location. Okay, so one location means we have to move SI pointer at the last location. Okay, so if you initialize it to 6, it will go here, and if you initialize to 7, it will point here. But we have to point to last position, that's why we have decremented this by 1. You will get clear about this at this instruction, RET move SP. Okay, then next instruction is LEA SI STR 1 plus 2. So load effective address SI STR 1 plus 2. So now SI will point at this location. SI will point at this location, str 1 plus 2 means first strings, first character, and LEA DI, str 1 plus 2 means DI will point to first character of string 2. Okay, and here CH is 00, previously see here CH is 00, CL is 06, so by combining this it will make CX 0006. And now SI is pointing to STR1 and DI is pointing to first character of STR2. Next instruction is repeat move SB. REP move SB. Move SB instruction is a move string byte instruction which will move the character or the string pointed by SI to the address which is pointed by DI. Okay. So move SB will simply copy this W here, but we have to move the entire string, that's why we are using repeat REP instruction, REP move SB. Now repeat until when? Until this CX becomes 00. Okay, I repeat, move SB instruction moves the contents pointed by SI to the address pointed by DI. So move SB instruction will copy this W at this location, but we want entire string to be copied here. Okay, so that's why we are using this repeat, REP. So how many times this operation will be repeated? This operation will be repeated till this CX becomes 00. Okay, so every time the character will be copied, SIDI will be incremented by 1 and CX will be decremented by 1. We will see this operation. See, first W is copied here, then SI is incremented by 1, DI is incremented by 1 and CX is decremented by 1. Next, E will be copied here, then SI, DI are incremented, CX is reduced by 1. This process is repeated till CX becomes 0. Now L is copied here, SI, DI incremented. This is happening with this single instruction only. Okay. Then C will be copied here, and SIDI incremented by 1, CX decremented by SIDI incremented by 1, CX decremented by 1. O is copied, then again SIDI incremented by 1, CX is decremented by 1. Now M is copied and SIDI both are pointing at the last location, and now CX is 0. Now see here, if the CX was 0007, then SI will stop here. But at this point we want SI to be pointing at the last position, as we have to make the reverse of the swing. That's why we decremented count, or we decremented length by 1 to stop SI here. Okay, so this repeat move SB instruction is used just to take this SI at last position. Okay, now next is move CL comma STR 1 plus 1. So again length will be transferred to CL register, original length 7. Then LEA DI comma STR 2 plus 2. So now DI is again updated, and again it is again pointing to the STR 2. Okay, first, because now we have to copy it reverse. So now DI is pointing to first character. Next instruction is loop 1 move DX comma SI. So whatever is pointed by DX whatever is pointed by SI, that will be moved to DX register. Move DX comma SI. Now SI pointing to location which contains the letter E. So E will be moved here, DX register. Then move DI comma DX. Move DI comma DX. Whatever is in here, DX will be copied here, E. And same, the letter in DX will be printed here, E. Move AH, 0 to INT 21H. Again, 0 to the letter or the contents of DX will be printed. So it will print E. Then decrement SI, increment DI, decrement CL. Decrement SI, increment DI, and as we have copied one character, decrement CL. SI will be decremented by 1, DI will be incremented by 1, and CL will be decremented by 1. Compare CL with 00, jump if not equal to loop 1. Means again it will go here. Again, move DX comma SI. So SI is pointing to this location. This location contains character M. Character M will be copied here, DX. Then this M will be copied here, move DI comma DX. This M will be copied here, and M will be printed here. Again, SI is decremented by 1, DI is incremented by 1, and CL, that is counter, is decremented by 1. Since counter is not 0, it will again go up. Then this O will be copied here. From here it will be copied here, O, and same will be printed here, O. Again SI is decremented by 1, DI is incremented by 1, and CL is also decremented by 1, 4. So after 7 iterations, when all the characters are processed, we get the reverse string here, and now SI is pointing at this location and DI is pointing at this location. So for each loop, a character pointed by SI is copied to DX register. From DX register, it is copied to the address which is present in DI register. Same character is printed here, and then SI is decremented, DI is incremented, and counter is decremented by 1. So now at this point counter is 0, means we have processed all the characters, and here we have reverse string also printed on the screen. So counter means CL register contains 00, so it will return to the main procedure from where it is called reverse. Again jump menu, so again it will jump to menu. Now let's consider that user enters choice 4. So now again AL will contain 34, same will be copied to BL register 34. So here compare BL comma 34, jump if equal to palindrome, so it will come here palindrome call pal, which contains the procedure for palindrome. First instruction is LEA DX STR 1 plus 2. So DX will point here, and now we are calling reverse procedure. See, palindrome, in palindrome we check the original string and reverse string. If original string, reverse string both are equal, that means string is palindrome. So to check whether string is palindrome or not, we have to first make the string reversed. So to make it reverse, we will call reverse. So it will call the reverse procedure, and just now we have seen that how the string is reversed. So likewise, welcome and its reverse is at str2. str1 is the original string and its reverse is at str2. Same output will be there. Next instruction is LEA DI STR 2 plus 2. LEA load effective address DI comma STR 2 plus 2. So now DI will point to first character from STR 2, and LEA SI comma STR 1 plus 2. So SI will point to the first character from STR 1. So now just we have to compare these characters. If all the characters are equal, means this is the original string, this is reverse string, and if the all characters are equal, it means that string is palindrome, right? So move AL comma, before that move CL comma STR 1 plus 1. Again length will be required to how many characters we have to compare will be defined by that. So CL is 07. Then come here, move AL comma byte pointer SI. So now SI is pointing to a character W, and that W character will be moved to AL register. Similarly, move BL comma byte pointer DI. DI pointed by the DI is pointing to address location which stores the character E, so that E will be shifted or E will be copied to BL. Okay. So this is taken in AL register, this is taken in BL register. Decrement CL, as we have copied one character, CL is decremented by 1. Compare it with 00. Jump if equal to loop X. No, it is not equal 0. So compare AL comma BL. Compare AL comma BL. Are they equal? Jump if equal to loop 3. Jump if equal to loop 3 means if they are equal, then increment means if the first character is equal, increment SI, increment DI means go to next character. Again check if they are equal. If they are equal, go further. But now see here, they are not equal, W and E, they are not equal. So as the first character itself is not equal, there is no need to check the further characters. So it will not jump to loop 3 because they are not equal. Jump if equal to loop 3. Compare AL comma BL. AL BL compared, they are not equal. If equal, jump if equal to loop 3, but they are not equal, so it will come here. Compare CL comma 00. Is CL 00? Jump if equal to loop 4. Means if CL is 00, then come here. But it is not 00, so display message 13. What is message 13? String is not palindrome. And then jump to loop 5. What is written in loop 5? Return. So it will return to the main procedure. Okay. So now consider that now we'll take example of one palindrome string and see how this procedure will be executed if string is palindrome. Okay. So now suppose user enters choice 4 and we have already a string in str is radar, R-A-D-A-R. This string is palindrome. If you read it from left to right, R-A-D-A-R, from right to left, R-A-D-A-R. So string is palindrome. Okay. So user enter choice 4. So it will come here. Called reverse. So R-A-D-A-R, reverse is R-A-D-A-R. Okay. So now SI is pointing here, DI is pointing here, then CL contains 0, 5, length of this string. Then these two instructions, move AL, byte pointer SI, move BL, byte pointer DI. So R is copied to AL, this R is copied to BL. They are equal, decrement CL, CL will be 4. Compare CL with 0, 0, no it is not 0. Compare AL, BL, they are equal. Jump is equal to loop 3. So what is written in loop 3? Increment SI, increment DI and jump to loop 2. So now see here, increment SI, increment DI. So SI and DI will point to second position and jump to loop 2. Jump to loop 2 means here. So again, these characters will be copied to AL and BL register. Counter will be decremented by 1, 3. Counter is not 0, so it will jump to loop 3. In loop 3, increment SI, increment DI and jump to loop 2. Again, loop 2, move these characters to AL and BL, DD, decrement counter by 1. They are equal, so again move to next position. Copy these characters to ALBL, decrement counter by 1. They are equal, again move to next position. Compare this RR, they are equal, counter is decremented by 1, 0, 0. So now here, compare ALBL, they are equal, if equal, compare CL, 0, 0. So CL is 0. Jump if equal to loop X, it will come here. Compare 0, 0. Jump if equal to loop 4. Loop 4, it will display message 12. Message 12 is string is palindrome. Okay. This is how the original string and reverse string are compared to check whether the string is palindrome or not. After this, now suppose if user enters choice 5, so compare BL with 35, jump to terminate. What is written in terminate? Move AH, 4CH, INT, 21H. This will terminate the program, aim, start and aim. Thank you very much. This is all about assembly language program for string manipulation operation. I hope my videos are helping you in studying the concepts of assembly language programming. If you like my video, please press like button and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for latest updates and more videos. Thank you.